Jill has already told you, I am a Catholic nun. You may wonder how we dress differently. That's because I am in India, and this is the normal, that's, we call it sari, and that's the costume of the normal women in India. So we, those of us who are working with the people in the villages, we have switched on to the costume sari. Okay, that's more accepted by the people. When we wear short dresses or habits, people don't have much respect. They don't look at us in a proper manner. Okay. Anyway, I just want to tell you what I'm doing there. I will explain, since you all are big enough to understand what happened to me in my life. As a nun, when I was working in an organization, a woman came to me asking for shelter. To them, it's okay to tell that, fine. Because they are big enough to understand. Normally, I avoid telling the story why I started the work, because it's too shocking. And it's going to shock you, but don't get worried, okay? As I was working as a nun in a cloister, in a convent, a woman came to me asking for shelter. This woman was 7 months pregnant. She told me that her husband is in love with another woman, and he's also an alcoholic and a very hot-tempered man, and has told this woman, you have to get out of the house. And poor this woman, she had nobody. She did not know where she should go. She is not an educated woman. So being our convent being very close to the slum, she came to me and asked me for shelter. It was not possible for me, as in the convent, you all know, I don't know whether how it is here, but normally in India, we don't take an outsider into the convent. And if it is more, if it is another religion. And this woman who came to me was a Hindu. So it was not possible for me to take her into the house. I sent her back, and that very night, her husband and she, they must have had some fight as usual, I don't know what has happened. He poured kerosene and set her on fire. This woman was 7 months pregnant. And I heard the shouting and yelling. So like any other onlooker, I also ran there to see, because it was very close to a slum. I don't know, some of the slum slides we will show you, then you will understand what it is. So being very close to the slum, I ran there to see what was happening. It was at that time I realized it was the same woman, because she came to me, save me, and she was shouting. And I saw, my God, I said, I don't know what I'm supposed to do now. Anyway, with the help of the people, I shifted her to the hospital. But you know, shifting a patient to the hospital from the village, it took me nearly 6 hours. Because we did not have any cars, there was nothing in that village. So by the time I organized everything, it took me quite a while. And I shifted her to the hospital, and when I reached her to the hospital, doctor told me that she is already fully burned, 90% burned. And I asked doctor if anything can be done to save the baby, because she was 7 months pregnant. But when doctor took her to the theater, you know, in the operation theater, and what we got in our hand was a fully burned baby, fully cooked baby. This was the incident that shook my entire life. I was really, what shall I call it, so angry with myself for not helping that woman when she came to me. I was blaming myself. I became a very, very angry person after that. Because I was never like that. I was a very sweet person, very adjusting. But when it came to, after this particular incident, I started noticing I was becoming very frustrated, very angry with myself. And I remember once I was at the table in the convent, I felt like turning my table round, because I felt there are so many women there suffering, and I'm having a nice breakfast. I just did not feel it. And then somebody told me, Lucy, I think it's time for you to go for some counseling. So fortunately for me, I went and I met a Catholic priest who guided me. And he said, Lucy, instead of getting frustrated and being here, go and do something for this type of women who are suffering. I did not know what I am going to do. I am not educated. I did not have the money. So what will I do was a big question. But I can tell you, God was walking with me. The divine grace was there and he allowed me to meet good people, especially a person from Austria. He and his son, they came down to India and they met me and they said, listen, we can help you. But I was dealing with a European person for the first time, so I did not know whether how much I can trust him. But before leaving India, he came down to India, he lived with me for a month, and before leaving, he gave me some money that was enough for me to buy a small piece of land. And now, in 1997, we set up our first home for women and children of such cases. From 97 to now, we were able to help out more than 2,400 such cases. And along with them came children. So we have now, we already had almost 2,300 children, because every woman who walked into Maher came with two and three and sometimes even six children. Not only that, what we did, we have a vehicle, so we go around on the streets of Pune, and whoever the children who are begging, we try to rescue these children. With children who are sold into prostitution, we rescue them. Children at the age of 6 and 9 are already sold into prostitution. So we bring out this, try to bring out these children. Then we also try to help out the children who are also working for construction as child labor. Now Gauss is one of my child. He has grown up with me for the past 14 years. I think Gauss, you should have come here. When we saw Gauss for the first time, he was only 7 years, and from the age of 6, he was washing cars and he was washing also plates in the hotels. Gauss, I think it would be nice if you can explain what you are doing and how you came to Maher. I'll come back to you when he finished speaking.
Okay, namaste everyone. My name is Gauss. I try to speak in English because some volunteers are coming to Maher and they taught us English. When I was small, like 6 years old, that time I was going to garage, washing the cars. Also going at night, I'm going to hotels, that washing the plates. Because my family condition was very poor. My father was paralyzed and he was always in the bed. My mother was so, he's doing so hard work for my family, because I had two sisters, one my grandmother, my father and my mother and me. I want to go to school, but I couldn't because we don't have enough money for eating. So how I go to school? Then I went to for the work and I get some money and I was giving my mother. But after some time I was working. At that time, one social worker came and he asked me, why are you doing? He came from Maher. So he came and he told me, why are you doing that type of work? Why are you not going to school? Then I said, I want to go to school, but we don't have enough money. We don't have money to buy notebook. We don't have money to go to school, giving the examination fees. Then he went to Maher and they're having some discussion with Didi. We call her Didi. And
that means auntie.
Yeah. She is my second mother. And they're having some discussion. And then after she came, at night, she came to my home and she asked me only one question. She asked me, dear child, you want to learn? You want to go to school? I said, yes. And she took me. So last 14 years, I belong with Maher. I'm living with Maher. Maher gives me lots of opportunities. I want to mention that, like in 2007, I got Best Actor Award in my whole Pune region. Then in 2007, I was selected for the WSF, it's called World Social Forum, which held in South Africa. But I couldn't win because I don't have my birth certificate, my residential address, so I don't have my passport, so I lost this opportunity.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. One minute. For Gauss, everything is new, okay? Especially when he came to Maher. When we gave him the first school bag, you should have seen his joy. And the same way, now, his experiences of coming to Europe. Because, you see, in his when I went to see him in the house, they were living, you know, smaller than this, in one room, all the people together, you know, just for not even 10 feet by 8 feet. was the room, okay? And that's how he has lived. And then afterwards, when he came to Maher, again, in a hall like this, more than 30 to 40 children sleep in that room. Okay, so they were sleeping together, eating together, praying together, everything together. And suddenly, when I brought him to UK, and people over here, they gave him the best room, the best bed. And then now he'll explain what happened to him being in a room alone.
You know, first time I slept alone in big room. We are sleeping on the floor. But I tried to sleep the
mattress.
The mattress. It was very soft. So I played whole night. And I tried to sleep, but I couldn't. But when I sleep, I fall down two times.
Okay, now I'm performing in front of you a dance, Indian classic dance called Kathak. So it is a type of classic. So I'm doing some footworks and some bowls.
The first step is of the worship, worshipping the divine.
Tiga 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 ti